Welcome to the final edition of the Nate Moore Show for this season. Our show is brought to you each week by Reliable Heating and Cooling. I'm your host, Calix Collins, here again with Coach Moore. Coach, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me on, Calix.
Coach, your Tigers lost to the Hoban Knights last Friday night in a Division II state semifinal game. I know you were disappointed, but at the same time, also very proud of this team.
Yeah, very proud of this team. I don't know that I've had a team that's come as far in one season. As far as play on the field, leadership, work ethic. It was a great year. Loved working with the guys, you know, as you. Tough ending.
Your team was playing from behind the entire night but kept fighting the whole game. Was there a specific moment or play in the game where you felt like you had some momentum or could come all the way back?
I mean, yeah, in the second half, I thought we came out and moved the ball much better. That was really the name of the game is we needed to accumulate first downs and get our defense off the field, which we struggled at in the first half. But the second half, we did a much better job of that.
In general, can you share with us what you told the team after the game?
Just that I'm proud of them and love them. You know, love that group of guys, love coming to work every day. Just sharing that moment with them and, walking around the locker room a little bit and just, you know, talking to guys, making sure that they're keeping their heads up and they're okay, because it's tough. It's a tough loss. You know, it's tough to handle. You got to remember, how far you've come and all the work that you put into it. And, we spent a lot of time together, as you know. So it's tough when a season ends, especially a season like that.
The Tigers played some very good teams this season. How does Hoban compare to some of those previous opponents?
I mean, Hoban was a great team. They're a great team. You know, they're the better team on the field that night. And, we played some really good teams during the course of the year as well. But, you got to go out and win the game, and we didn't do that.
What are some of the things you'll remember most about the 2022 Massillon Tigers?
I mean, how far we came, really, like I said at the beginning, especially leadership-wise and especially your class, the seniors. I thought that we, when we started, leadership wasn't something that I would have said we had a ton of. But towards the end of the year, I thought that we did a much better job with that, and we had some guys really take the bull by the horn and step up, and I was really happy with that.
Thanks, Coach. In a moment, we'll talk with the Tiger player, but first, this word from Reliable Heating and Cooling.
There was a time when 10 miles to the gallon was acceptable. Today's 40-plus mile-per-gallon cars weren't even in the rearview mirror back then. Of course, this Lennox air conditioner wasn't on the radar either. It's solar ready, the quietest, most energy efficient air conditioner you can own. It's time to live in the now.
Call Reliable Heating and Cooling for the most advanced technology in heating and air conditioning. When you're ready to live in the now, call Reliable Heating and Cooling.
Lennox, innovation never felt so good.
Thank you, Reliable Heating and Cooling. Joining me now is senior co-captain and running back Will Hartson. Trell, welcome to the show. First of all, congratulations on a great season. I knew you were disappointed about how the season went and ended last week. But overall, what will you remember most about this team?
I probably remember most all summer us hanging out, running after 110s, playing, having fun.
You were also a co-captain this season. Tell us more about how you handled those responsibilities.
Making sure I do my schoolwork, being a good captain, making sure when I'm doing everything right around the school and on the field and out of school.
You set several new running back records this season here at Maslin. Have you had a chance to think more about that?
Now I do, and yes, I'm happy I did. I'm thanks to the line. They helped me do it in the team.
Who are some of the guys on this team you're close with, and what does it mean to you to have shared this great season with them?
My closest friends is Marcus, Angelo, you, and other guys on the team, and spending all my time here and ending my high school career was really great, having fun with them, and most of the time having fun in the field with them.
What would your message be to the juniors and sophomores who will be coming back next season?
Make sure you stay on top of your grades and never be satisfied, and always work hard in the workout room.
Right. Well, thanks, Wiltrell. Coach Moore will rejoin us after we take a timeout on the Nate Moore Show.
STEM is everywhere, like here, behind the scenes of The Walking Dead.
Cut, we got it.
And for every moment like this, there's a crew of people using STEM to bring the dead to life.
We had 30 minutes to make one of Norman Reedus's outfits look 7 years old. When we break down clothes, we tumble it with trisodium phosphate, rock salt, and dish detergent.
We stitched together images of our model and created a 3D set that could be walked through in a VR headset. It looked like you were actually standing in the room.
There's so much technology involved in directing. We're able to turn 12 walkers into a 1,000 walker horde.
That idea became this design, which turned into this set, and that costume worn by that walker who was having a really bad day. STEM can create new worlds on and off the screen. What will you make with STEM? Get inspired at shecanstem.com.
Welcome back to the Nate Moore Show. Coach, we just heard from senior co-captain and running back Wiltrell Hartson. What are some of the personality traits that Wiltrell possesses that you've observed in the past couple of seasons?
Wiltrell's a highly motivated kid, young man. That's really what is the defining characteristic for him. He's not going to let anybody outwork him. He's a guy that's always doing extra. We even have to pull the reins back on sometimes, because you can do too much. And it's a tremendous work ethic, very goal-oriented individual. Ton of respect for Wiltrell.
Let's look ahead to next season. You have quite a few juniors and sophomores expected to return. How do you feel about the guys you'll have back next season?
We feel good. We do return a lot of guys on both sides of the ball. There's a lot of water to cross before we really know what we have with that group. If we're going to go on another run, it starts with leadership. Leadership's going to have to be great, and hopefully that starts at the very beginning.
When does your off-season program begin, and what does the schedule look like?
We start back January 4th. We're 3 days a week through 2 weeks before spring break. And then we move to a four-day-a-week schedule from there on out.
Okay. Is next year's schedule complete?
It is not.
Do you have any games that are already set?
We have a couple.
In what weeks are you still looking for opponents?
We're still looking for opponents in week 7 and week 6.
Okay. So I have one more question for you.
Sure.
See, because of the whole Thanksgiving thing last year.
Okay.
Were you team gravy train or were you team cranberry?
Oh, man. I like them both. But it's hard to beat a good gravy.
Oh, I like that. We want to thank Coach Moore and senior co-captain Wiltrell Hartson for joining us in the show this week. The Nate Moore Show has been brought to you all season long by Reliable Heating and Cooling. I'm your host, Calix Collins. Thanks for watching, and as always, go Tigers.
Hey, Hello, and welcome to the Stark County Humane Society. Today we're going to give you a few pointers when considering adopting a new furry friend. All animals here at the Stark County Humane Society are spayed, neutered, microchipped, vaccinated, dewormed, and if old enough, heartworm tested for our canine friends. Adopters will receive a free exam within 2 weeks of adoption at local veterinarian hospitals. We encourage all adopters to take full advantage of this. A one-time adoption fee is required for your new furry friend. When you adopt, you get an awesome adoption packet that includes treats for your new fur baby and savings for you. But this is not where the cost of adoption stops. Did you know the average cost of an animal like a new puppy or kitten can cost up to $500 annually? This includes annual veterinarian visits, preventative care, and everyday supplies like crate, litter, food, toys. But I hope this doesn't scare you away. Adopting an animal is a huge responsibility and a commitment. Please take the time to consider the cost of adopting a new pet into your family today. I hope to see you soon at the Stark County Humane Society. Please visit our website or visit us on social media for more information.
Around here, we like to cheer for the local team, and MCTV is here to connect you to the game. MCTV provides reliable high-speed internet and Wi-Fi. From checking scores online, to streaming games or watching replays, or even playing the game yourself, we've got the speed you need. Call today to add or upgrade internet service. We're connecting what matters most. MCTV. We go the extra mile.